I've seen your goodness on the mountain. I felt your love down in the valley. And your grace still surrounds me. You've been good to me. You've been good to me. I've seen goodness on the mountain. Your love down in the valley, and your grace still surrounds me. You've been good to me. You've been good to me. My soul sings. My soul. Inside my body, because of you, Lord, and I have life inside my bones, and I cannot help but pray. Inside my bones, and I cannot help but praise you. Lord, you've been good to me. Yes, you've been good to me. And my soul sings. My soul sings. Yeah.
So interested in our hearts. He's interested in our hearts. In this moment, let's just make it the best we can give him. The best gift that we can give to him, who is so worthy. Let us hold nothing back from him. Let us draw near to the living God.
Surroundings.
Oh, we have an opportunity just to be very close. Jesus, the righteous judge. Let us purify our hearts. Let us turn to him, holding nothing back. Touch where you will touch, oh Lord God. Every heart, Lord God. Just be prepared for the Lord to speak to you. The Lord will speak, hallelujah. He will speak. Even you children, the Lord will speak to you. Doesn't matter how big, how little you are, Jesus will speak to you. He wants you to know him. And we're bare before you, Lord. Bare before you, Lord.
I feel like one of the things that God wants to do today is to break off the fear of man from us. It's that fear that won't allow us to speak to somebody else about Jesus, because we're fearful of how they will react to us, what they're going to say, what they're going to think about us. Well, God wants us to be more fearful of him than to be fearful of man. And in this day and age where everybody's speaking out about this and about that, and they're getting shot down right and left for it, God said, now it's time for my people to stand up and to speak. But we can't speak if we're afraid to speak. So today, God wants to break that off of us. He wants to free us so that, because the day is getting darker, it's not going to get any better. And God said, I need my people to be able to stand and speak for me. Be more afraid of God than you are of man.
I remember when I first got saved, I didn't want anybody to know. I didn't want my neighbors to know. I didn't want anyone to know, because I knew they would look at me and judge me the way I used to look and judge them. And it wasn't pretty. I praise God. He delivered me of that. He delivered me from that, not wanting anyone to know that I loved the Lord my God. You know, our God is awesome. He's awesome. I just want to declare over us a spirit of the fear of the Lord, that we would indeed fear him more than any other thing, person, or place. So, Father, I ask right now for a spirit of fear of the Lord to come upon us right here, right now. Come, come. Send your spirit in fear of the Lord. I ask in Jesus' name.
Amen. I rest under the shadow of your wings. My God, I trust your grace to work in me. My God, is better than life. Almighty God, you part the seas and calm the raging storms with just one word. Almighty God, you purchase me, redeem me with your love. You have set the captives free. I hear you say, be still and know that I am God. Be still. Season calm the raging
Chains broke. the Spirit of the